I bet you never warm up properly. Okay, just kidding. I don't blame you, but I had to start this video somehow. However, this problem is legit. I think we can agree with that. You just need to look around in the park or the gym. Most people don't warm up at all, or if they do so, it's not enough or efficient. Of course, it depends on the type of movement or sport you're about to do, but in this video, I'll talk about bodyweight training, calisthenics, or street workout, and I'm gonna show you a 5-minute warm-up routine you should do before every workout. What's up guys, it's Adam from gymnasticsmethod.com. If you don't want to miss the new videos about bodyweight training and lifestyle, please subscribe and click on the bell. Thank you. And if you want to get access to all the Gymnastics Method programs, tutorials, nutrition, daily workouts and much more, click the link below and join the Gymnastics Method community today. Before we start, let's talk about the basics. Actually, I want to start with a very basic misunderstanding. Doing 20, 30, 60 or 100 push-ups, pull-ups, muscle-ups is not a proper warm-up, neither if you're an advanced athlete. This is a huge misunderstanding. Just because something is easy for you, it doesn't mean that those exercises are warm-up exercises. Not to mention that those athletes or trainers who show this example just mislead people who in most cases are not able to do these exercises properly or not able to do them at all. But they think that's the right way because XY trainer or athlete did and said so. A lot of people also think that because these exercises are just bodyweight exercises, they can be used as a warm-up. Yes, they can be used as a part of a specific warm-up, and you also need to do some exercises before you do them. So, what's the proper warm-up and why is it important? Warm-up is something that everybody knows they should do, but they don't do, or they get it done with some arm circles or a 5-minute treadmill. However, if you do the warm-up properly, you could benefit from it more than you think. In general, it really is just that, transitioning your body from the inactive state to the state in which you can do a workout. It also means physiological changes such as redistribution of blood circulation, for instance, blood flow from internal organs to muscles, increase in body temperature, oiling of joints, changes in muscle elasticity and tone, and so on. These positive effects help to avoid injuries on the one hand, and they are key to maximize performance on the other hand, something that many don't know or don't think about. So, if avoiding injuries so far hasn't been enough motivation to do a proper warm-up, maximizing performance should be a great motivation to do so. The workout will be better, you'll feel stronger, your body will function more efficiently. There is another important aspect that I'd like to highlight. This is the retuning of the nervous system, reviving nerve-muscle connections. This is important for both general warm-up and specific warm-up. If you understand the following thought and warm up properly with that in mind, you'll realize that you can do a lot to prevent injuries and increase your performance. Story time. Imagine that you have a map in your brain that contains all the movements that you're able to do. Let's call it the movement body map. Your secure and known movements are sharp on this map, and those movements that you do insecure are faded, blurred, you can barely see them. Besides that, you have empty areas on the map because you never explored those. Those areas are for the movements that you have never done before, but if you'll do so, you'll have the space for them and you can put those on the map consistently. On the sharp areas, you move with confidence because you already learned those movements, even on a professional level, so you don't even need to pay that much attention to them. On the other hand, on the faded, blurred areas, you're insecure, your nervous system is awake, tense, maybe in a state of fear. In this situation, you may be exposed to unexpected effects, overcompensation, or injuries. Therefore, it's important to move as versatile as possible in terms of warming up, to move your body in as many joint range of motion as possible, because in this way you also develop your nervous system and muscle nerve connections. You will sharpen and expand the map. You prepare your body for possible unexpected situations where your nervous system will not engage in a defense mechanism, but will handle them with more confidence. I hope this is easy to understand. So with this in mind, doing a proper warm-up routine, you can prevent injuries and reduce their risk. It's important to distinguish between general warm-up and specific warm-up. What I personally consider important and classify into a separate category is the joint preparation or prehab exercises that I usually recommend and use with my students as a routine after the general gymnastic and isolation warm-up. So just to sum up, I suggest the following types and order. First, general warm-up with gymnastic exercises and isolations. Second, joint preparation or prehab exercises. And third, specific warm-up, which can be a regression of a particular exercise if it gives the option of gradation, and it's worth warming up with a lighter version before we get into the exercise itself. For example, if you're doing one-arm pull-ups, you may want to prepare your nervous system and joints with a few regular pull-ups or commando pull-ups. In this video, I show you an example of the first point, so general warm-up with gymnastic exercises and isolations that can be done in just 5 minutes. If you're interested about the mentioned joint preparation or prehab routine, or you want to follow the gymnastics method workout programs, learn a new exercise like handstand, body levers, or planche, click the link below and join on gymnasticsmethod.com. And now, let's see the 5-minute routine for general warm-up. I recommend to do this routine before every workout. You'll feel the difference and you'll be able to avoid injuries doing this short 5-minute routine. If you want to get access to all the Gymnastics Method programs, tutorials, daily workouts, nutrition, and much more, click the link below and join right now. Thank you for watching. I hope you found it helpful. Leave a thumbs up, share with your friends who don't warm up, and write a comment. What do you want to see in the next video? Don't forget to subscribe and click on the bell for more, and see you next time.